Like, can you ready the environment for folks before they're even there? And how do you even go about thinking about that?
Do I redo my guest room every time somebody comes over? No, but my guest room is an extension of my home. It truly is. It looks like a thrift store threw up in here, right? They know what it's like to stay in the Oaks house, but I do account for my individual guests as much as I can. But if I had to give the advice directly to the company about creating that environment, it would be to focus on the operations. You discover so much more when you dig into, like, how do we actually get our work done? What are we actually focused on? There's a lot of things, a lot of behavior in almost every organization that I've been in that is extremely inefficient and unproductive. When we focus on that, we start to empower our employees. We give them hope that change can happen. We start to find out things that are outside of the operational lens as well, because now they feel empowered. Now we're building trust. Now we're working in work teams of cross-functional people across the organization who are getting to know each other. Right now we're really identifying what are we doing now, and then who do we need in order to help us get there? And that, when we talk about can we prepare a place for them, yes, and we can do it in an even more grounded and self-aware way of, just like Anna's house, you're not going to come into my guest room and have like the modern hotel experience. I'm not trying to be that, right? That's not who this culture is here. But I do know that this is my environment and I'm welcoming anybody in. And if you want to change anything around in there, you want to change it, she says yours, right? So like really prepare the place for them and then allow them to make space for themselves.